Hi, my name is JasonMorrell, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a multi-level list like this, where we have a mixture of uppercase Roman numerals, numbers, and letters, and lowercase Roman numerals. And more than that, we have this one ABC system, where all the letters after A don't have a number in front. If you haven't watched my previous videos on multi-level lists, or you'd like to get this finished template for yourself, please check out the notes beneath this video. So here we are on a clean document. I've pasted all the text from the other document into this one and just reset it to the normal style so that nothing is styled. You'll notice a couple of extra headings, these heading 2 hiddens, which weren't on the previous example I just showed you. That will become evident while we've done that as we go through the process. So let's select all this text here. Let's go to the multi-level list icon and down the bottom here, define new multi-level list. Now it doesn't really matter where you start. If your current numbering says 1, 1.1, 1.1.1, or if it says 1AI, or any other system that you may have used before, it doesn't matter because in this video, I'm going to do it all from scratch, wipe out what's there, and rebuild it. So here we are on level 1. So where it says enter formatting for number, the top level was the uppercase Roman numerals. So I've wiped out what's there, and where it says number style for this level, I'm going to choose the uppercase Roman numerals, that's III III, and down the bottom, align it is 0, which means the number itself is on the margin, and indent the text that follows it by 1 centimeter. Now also, I'm going to click the More button to expand the dialog here, and link level 1 to heading 1. This is what I do in all of my videos, and it's what I recommend that everybody does, because when you control your numbering by styles, it becomes so much more easier to manage. So let's move to level 2. Now level 2 is actually going to be used to reset the numbering to 1, 2, 3. And that's where that heading 2 hidden style comes into play. So you don't actually see this on the final result, but it's there to control and reset the numbering where it's needed. So for this one, I'm not going to include a level number from the level above because it's not important. But what I am going to do is to choose a 1, 2, 3 numbering system here. It also doesn't matter where you align it. It could be any system at all here, any figures at all, because you don't actually see this. That's actually going to be hidden. And just to finish off, I'm going to say link it to heading 2. So that's level 1 and 2 done. Now level 3 is where we start with the 1A followed by the B, C, D and so on. So let's go to level 3. Again, I'm going to wipe out whatever's in enter formatting for number, rebuild it from scratch. Now level 3 needs to say 1A. So for this, I need to pick up the level from level 2 and then follow it with a number style for this level. Now I've actually noticed when I chose level 2 here, it didn't actually insert into this enter formatting for number. Now that sometimes happens if you don't pick up from the top level. So if that ever happens, just come down here and choose level 1 followed by level 2. It actually puts two numbers in here, one for level 1, one for level 2. And then after there, you can actually just delete the level 1 number. The one that's left is the one from level 2. Now, in an ideal world, what we could do here is to press Control Tab. And what this does is it moves across a set distance from the previous content. And the default tab position is 1.27 centimeters, which is the old half inch. However, Word is very buggy. So even though you can do that here, and it works for the first time out, once you close Word and come back in again, that tab position actually disappears and becomes a space. So I'm not even going to bother using that this time. I am just simply going to put a space in and then pick up the number style for this level, which is the uppercase ABC. So that's how we get the 1A for that first bit of the sequence. Again, I'm going to come down and align it at 1 centimeter this time. So this level's indented and pick it up at 2 centimeters for the text that follows the number. As you can see, it starts at A. It restarts after level 2, which is the hidden level, or it will be once we've changed the style. And we're going to link the level to style, heading 3. So that's the third level done. Now level 4, this is where we want to pick up the B, C, D and onwards. And all we've got to do for this one is to choose number style for this level, and we choose the uppercase ABC. But rather than starting at A, we start it at B. Now, the aligned at and text indent at, this is where it starts to become a little bit interesting. If we had the tab positions that worked and were retained by Word, this would be easy. But because we're using the space, we have to kind of guess. So, because the 1A has the number and then the letter, but for the B we just have the letter, I'm going to guess at say 1.4 centimetres. If it's not right, you can always come back in and change it later, but start off somewhere where you think it might be and use that as your starting point. The text that follows can still be 2 centimetres, so that the text that follows A and B and C is always the same distance forward. So we're starting at B, we're restarting after level 3, we're restarting the numbering after level 3, and link level to style, I'm going to make that heading 4. Level 5 is the last level. Now this is the lowercase Roman numerals. So let's come down here, let's wipe out what's in here. Let's put this level Roman numerals inside brackets. So I'm going to start with an open bracket. The number style for this level is going to be lowercase III III. Let's close the bracket. Let's align it at 3 centimetres and text indent at 4 centimetres. Check it over here. We start at I, restart after level 4, and we're going to link the level to style, heading 5. So that's the setup done. You can see over here roughly how it's going to look. It's not to scale, but it gives you an idea of the numbering and the sequence of the numbering. So at this point, I'm happy. Let's click OK. So let's start applying some of these headings. Now at the top here, you've got your styles gallery, and you can go through and pick up the heading 1, 2s and 3s from here if you want to. But I find it easier to click this launcher and have the sidebar ready to go. It only displays the first two at the beginning, but as you use heading 2, heading 3 will become active. As you use heading 3, heading 4 will become active, and so on. Or what you can also do is to click the options down the bottom here, and instead of recommended, you can just say all styles, if that's your preference. Anyway, let's go to heading 1 here. Let's set that to heading 1, and you can see it's applied the heading 1 style. And as you can see, we have our first top level heading, the uppercase Roman numeral I. Let's take the two heading 2s here and apply the heading 2 styles. Let's take the heading 3s and apply the heading 3 styles. Let's take the heading 4s, there's 2 there and 2 there, and apply the heading 4 style. And let's pick up the rest, these are all heading 5s, and apply the heading 5 styles. These are just the default heading styles that Microsoft give you. It's all kind of based around the blue theme, unless you change your theme. The first thing I'm going to do is to come to these heading 2 hidden lines and modify the styles so that first of all they're hidden, but also they're red when they're displayed. And this will make sense once I take you through the process. So over here, I'm going to right click on heading 2 and choose modify. I'm going to first of all change the font color here to bright red. And also down in the format button under font, we can choose the hidden tick box or checkbox and click OK. Now straight away you see they disappeared over here, and that's okay, that's what they're meant to do. If you click this button here, it's called the show hide, the little symbol there is called a pilcro. When you click on this, it shows all the hidden formatting, and that's when you can see your hidden styles popping up. The purpose of these, of course, as a refresher, is to reset the numbering to 1, so that we can have 1A, and then 2A, and then 3A, all under that top level heading. The second thing I'm going to do, you see how the heading 3s and heading 4s are slightly different sizes, but actually they're part of the same list. You want it to go 1ABC, really they should all be the same size. So I'm going to come across here, I'm going to check what the current settings are for heading 3, and we can see they're size 12, let's actually make that a little bit bigger, maybe a size 16. And then do the same thing for heading 4. So modify those, make that a size 16 as well, so they're both the same size, and click OK. And if you want to make the top level heading a little bit bigger so it makes more sense, we can come across to heading 1, right click and modify, and make this maybe a size 20, or something nice and big, representing a major heading. It's also a slightly different color there, I think, so it's kind of a darkest blue and a lighter blue. You can change that if you modify your styles as well. So everything's behaving as it should. Of course, you can hide these heading 2s again anytime by clicking this button here. But before we do that, let's just test and create more content to continue the numbering further down. So if I come down and choose this one here, so the whole of the number 2 onwards, I'm just going to copy that and paste it beneath. and you can see that it's picked up 3 and everything is continuing as it should. So when we hide the hidden stuff now, all the numbering makes sense. You got top level I, 1ABC, 2ABC, 3ABC. And also it's worth picking up from the very top level as well. So maybe I'll copy this section here, paste that right down the bottom as well. And as you can see, this new top level heading has picked up the Roman numerals double I. The numbering has been reset to 1 for the ABC, so everything there is working properly. That's all done and dusted. So I hope you found value in this video. Your numbering system or the numbering system that you need might not be exactly like this, but take away some of the principles of what it's just been through and apply it to the numbering you need to create. There's always a way to get these things done. So if you have any questions or you found any of this video useful, post your comments and questions beneath this video. I always love reading those and I do respond to every single question and comment. So that's it for today. I shall see you for the next one. See you now.